Hey everyone, welcome back to another vlog. I am getting ready to go into Fairway, which is a regional small grocery store. Let me know what the grocery store in your area is. Not like the Super Target or the Walmart, but like the dedicated grocery store. I know like down south they have Publix, Kroger, there's like a Piggly Wiggly type of thing. I don't know. We have Hy-Vee and Fairway here. So let me know in the comments below your grocery store. I just got done dropping the dogs off at the groomer for their ultimate spa package, and poor Teddy just shook with fear the whole drive there. Get in, he's just like, I didn't bring my dad with me. Normally I like to have him come with me and then I take the dogs in one at a time, but he's just, you know, he had a surgery last week with on his hand, and you know, when you're 90, even a surgery on your hand kind of leaves you not feeling great. So I don't want to have him in the car jostling around. It's better to just keep him home and he can rest. And then I can run some errands, including going to this Fairway, because no matter how many grocery stores there are in your area, I feel like you can only get certain things at one. And there are certain things I only seem to be able to find at Fairway. So I will go in and see if I can find those. And then I'm going to the bank. And then I'll go home, and by the time I get home, they'll probably text and say dogs are ready, and I'll have to turn back around and come back out. But that's okay, because they get a bath, they get their ears cleaned, their teeth brushed, their anals done, their nails. They get all massaged, and you'd think Teddy was being taken to a torture chamber. He's so afraid. They all come out, and they're like, oh, come on, Teddy. And they hug him and snuggle him. The last time they were there, their groomer told me that she was drying another dog, and Teddy, well, maybe she was drying Charlie, and Teddy and another dog that he didn't even know, they went together and hid in a corner and were like all cuddled up together because they were afraid of the dryer. Oh my gosh. I just thought that, I mean, I don't want to be afraid, but that's just adorable to think. I don't know. So funny. He's at home and he's just a wild man, but then when around other people are out, he's terrified. And it's because he didn't get socialized as a puppy, because when I brought him home, he'd been home and then the pandemic started. And so any normal attempt that I'd have, like maybe people would come over and meet him and play with him, or I'd take him places, that all got scrapped. So he did not get to meet other dogs or people or anything. And then of course became very territorial of the house and of us. And yeah, poor little guy. But anyway, I'm dreading going in. I'm like, do I want to wear my mask? Nobody masks, but they're like, now you don't have to mask. But then the CDC is like, you should mask. So I'm going to wear a mask in the grocery store. I didn't wear one when I dropped them into the groomer. Eventually, we're just not going to have to mask anymore, I guess. But it's still that, like, do I really want to go in? I mean, I can kind of social distance here. Unlikely in a state sale or something where I can't. The thing is, I have to wear my glasses. And I can't, the dang glasses fog up with the mask. I know I get so many tips like of how not to do that. I can't get it to work. Mine still fog up because I'm also old and hot. And I just can't not get them to fog up. So it's like glasses or mask, which one's it going to be? So I don't know what to do. But I need my glasses when I'm in a store because I can't see a distance. It's all blurry. This getting old thing is just for the birds. Whoever invented this, I don't know. Okay, enough stalling. Got time to go grocery shop. I decided we're gonna have tacos for dinner. So I got some tomatoes for my dad, and I need lettuce in the bag, so I'm not cutting it. All right, they have the best produce at Fairway for sure. Oh, some carrots. Oh my, look at these little tiny grapes. My dad likes those like super sweet cotton candy ones, but they don't have them at every store or even like all the time. I don't see them here. He used to eat the mandarin oranges. Now he won't eat those. Used to get him those. Now he won't eat them. I don't see any of those super sweet grapes, so I'm not going to get anything because they'll just go to waste. He hasn't been eating. I got that pineapple spears at Sam's Club last week, if you watched that vlog, and he does like those, so that's been good. Do we have any up here? No, those are just the regular. Look at these teeny blueberries. Everything's so small. This is where I used to come to get his mug root beer, but, and he only likes it in the bottles, so he don't have that. But he has been drinking the A&W just fine, so. And I can get that at Target, so I guess I don't need to bother with that today. My dad used to eat these granola bars and things, but he won't eat them anymore. I just think it's so hard for him to chew. But I had to laugh at this. Regular $2.98, on sale for $2.88. Ooh, let's get that 10 cent savings. All right, here's something I can only get here that my dad loves, and it's this cream chip beef. So I'm gonna, grab a few for the freezer. I saw this TikTok the other day about making homemade pretzel bites with biscuit dough, but we're completely out here. Something else I was wanting to get my dad. I think he will eat these. They really don't have much here either. And he will not eat the waffles. I was actually kind of wanting French toast sticks, but do we not make those here? What's going on? I haven't seen French toast sticks for ages. I thought you used to be able to buy them. I don't know. Not here. Vandekamp's fish is another one I can only get at Fairway. Now, I should say I could probably get it at Walmart or Hy-Vee. I just don't go there. So, let's see here. Fish thing. Oh, gosh. I don't know what to choose. Crunchy battered or beer battered? Which one do we usually get? Does anyone know? Now I don't know. Okay, they didn't have tater tots at Target. And I don't see them here either. Sweet potato, but just regular tater tots, they are out here too. They only have Fairway brand, and I do not like Fairway brand food. I find it to be not good quality. They have rounds. I don't like those. I want mini tater tots. Crispy. Are they mini though? Woo! Back in the car. Here's a look at the parking lot. I did end up getting some tater tots. There was a bag that said extra crispy. The reason I like the mini tater tots is because they get crispier. But I don't like the crispy rounds for some reason. It's all the same product. Do I sound crazy? Yes. But I got regular sized tater tots that claim to be extra crispy. So we shall see. I also got the beer battered fish. I don't think you say beer. I just think you say batter. That threw me off. Got my dad his chipped beef. They did not have the mug root beer, but he is drinking A&W. So that is okay. So did I get everything that I went in there for? I didn't get the biscuits, but that's not a big deal. I just wanted to make the TikTok pretzels. So yeah, now I'm going to go to the bank. Another thrilling vlog. At McDonald's, getting Papa a Frappe. This is the third McDonald's I've been to this week, like different McDonald's. I think there are six in the area, so I've hit three this week. We're getting all over the place.
Hi, may I take your order, please?
A large caramel frappe.
Give me just one moment, please.
Hi, may I take your order, please?
Get my cute bag I got for my birthday. Isn't it cool? It is a... Is it an Isaac Mizrahi, I think it might be? I don't know. I got it at TJ Maxx. I love it. Puffy puffer purse.
Teddy. Oh, look at you and your little bandana, Teddy. Oh, it's so cute. Did you go to the groomer? Oh, you're wagging your tail. You're such a happy boy. You're a good boy, aren't you? You're so scared going there. But then you come home and you're okay. Oh my gosh, adorable.
Well, once again, we end up in my bedroom. Such a mess. I have been recording Celebrity Big Brother. I've not watched an episode, and there's six. Do I want to get into it now? No, I don't even know. I don't know. But anyway, I thought I would end this vlog. I got home with the dogs, and I just had work to do around the house. I have been working on another book, laundry, all the things, and then dinner. I'm just exhausted. So anyway, here we are at night again, but I thought I would open this box on camera. It's a subscription box. It is the Women's Collective box. I didn't realize that I was still subscribed to this. I thought I only got it once, but apparently I got it twice. So yeah, this is a box that features women artisans or women-owned companies, I guess I should say. I don't think it's all artisans, but anyway, I'll link them below if you want to check out their site. So the second time I've gotten the box, and if we can just dip in here. Okay, first thing we have is a tote bag. Oh, that's handy. Support your local small biz. And it's got a string on it. Just a pink canvas tote. Oh, it's pretty thick though. That's good. I will be taking that to the estate sales, supporting the local estate sales. Oh, it's very nicely packaged. There's no card or anything with it other than like you just get this, but it doesn't tell you anything about the stuff. So that's always a little odd. But this is a travel candle from Simply Curated, made in Grand Rapids, amber and cardamom. Oh, well, let's see if I can get this open with one hand. Can I do it? Maybe. Righty tighty. Okay, there it is. Oh, hello. Ooh. Very woodsy, very kind of a manly candle, which I'm more into, like, oh, why do I keep smelling it when I really don't like it? I like more fruity vanilla scents. This is very woodsy type. So there's that. Then we have, oh, Beloved Hot Cold Therapy Pack. Now, this is very useful because between my dad and I, somebody's always needing a hot pack or a cold pack. Does it have instructions with it? However, yes. So you can put it in the microwave or you can put it in the freezer. So these are actually really like this. And this is really a nice size for forehead, back of the neck, which is where I usually use an ice pad. Okay, we have got a little pouch here. And inside says My Retreat Jewelry. Oh, little piece of jewelry. Okay. Maybe. Try to do this one-handed, you know. Trying to be all fancy. And it is a very delicate, I'm assuming this is an ankle bracelet. No, that's too big for an ankle. It is a very tight necklace, or is it just tucked in there? Kind of. Yeah, it's looped around there. But it's My Retreat Jewelry. But that's all we've got. With the gold necklace. And, oh, got something tucked under here. It is a little bowl. You know, there's nothing with this box that tells you what the stuff, where it's from. Mint Mocha Body Scrub. Kind of looks like it's chunked up. Well, it's body scrub. Mint Mocha. So, it's a cute little trinket dish. I mean, I know nothing about it. Doesn't give you any information. And a bazillion things of packing material, which will go into my eBay box. Now, speaking of eBay, if you watched my previous video, I said that I was putting some things up for auction on eBay this week, and that is a lie. The things I showed you, the toys, will not be going up for auction because once I got into them, they had been in just like storage since I bought them at auction. I noticed some issues with some of them, and I don't like to sell things with issues because I don't want people to be disappointed and, you know, people don't read the description. And I'm not exactly sure how the things should work. So like the little Disney thing that pops up, some of the things make noise, some don't. So I feel like, okay, that's an issue. The little Mickey Mouse piano, it doesn't really work very well. Sometimes the lid won't go down again and sometimes it won't pop up. And then the Bugs Bunny Jack in the Box, they had a little issue with the noise on it. So I am going to take those things to the consignment store because they do take vintage toys. So if you watched my last vlog and saw things that I was going to list on eBay, I am sorry that I didn't. I will also tell you that when I brought it all upstairs to look it over, I was trying to lug up boxes and I dropped everything, it fell on the floor. And I'm like, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? I do not need to list this big bulky stuff on eBay. So anyway, speaking of eBay, I don't think that guy paid for his, actually, I don't think he did. I need to go and file a claim because this person has not paid for the G.I. Joe toy lot. So that's fantastic. Let me look that up right now. Well, still haven't paid, so can I file a claim yet? Is it cancel order? They've done this differently. Cancel order? What's your reason? Buyer hasn't paid. Okay. I'm not going to relist it. I am going to see if there's a second chance offer. Okay, there are some second chance offers. This person bid $35, and I'm going to just do a one day. See if they want it for $35. Send that. And if this person doesn't buy it, I will relist it for the week. So anyway, got that done. And like I said, I've shown another vlog. Vintage Herky is up. The Pepsi cooler is up. I have some more dollhouse furniture. I don't know if I'm going to get it up this week or not because I'm working on some book stuff and that is my priority. So anyway, that's going to end this vlog. Another, I didn't know if it's a very interesting vlog, but maybe you liked the grocery store footage. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. Of course, make sure you're subscribed. And I will see you guys in the next vlog. I'm going to be going to estate sales tomorrow. So that will be the next video for you. So definitely be on the lookout for that. And I will see you then. Bye.